Happy Mother's Day once again.
再次母亲节快乐。
Tonight, I want to tell all the fathers.
今天我要跟所有的父亲讲。
When you go and celebrate Mother's Day for your wife,
当你在为着你的妻子庆祝母亲节的时候
，bring a calculator along.
你记得带计算机。
Because you need that to sum up all her immeasurable love.
因为你要去计算她所有的爱。
And you need to bring a ruler along.
然后你要带尺。
Because you want to measure how much she has loved you.
因为你要去衡量她有多爱你。
Okay, I'm just responding to Charlotte's joke, lah. Okay, that's why.
我刚才只在。
Don't worry, I tell you, I just want to say that all mothers, we printed a prayer card for you.
所以所有的母亲们，我们其实有列印了一张祷告卡给你们。
So those are the prayer cards. You know, we will encourage mothers. You can pray along that for your family, for your children, and may that be an encouragement to you.
我们祷告你，我们希望能够用那个卡来一起的祷告，为了你家庭祷告，为了孩子祷告。
Awesome.All good?
还好吗
？Happy?
还开心吗
？Turn to someone who is not a mother. Ask them when do you like to become a mother.
跟你旁边那些还没有当妈妈的人说，你什么时候要当妈妈
？Okay, all right. Okay, awesome. I thought something interesting. Thanks, Elaine. I have three kids.
我有三个孩子。
And this year, my daughter finally went to secondary school, high school.
今年呢，我的女儿会上中学。
她已经上了中学。
已经上中学了。
Okay, so, I thought maybe it's time to split the genders by room.
我觉得说就是就是房间应该要分开，男生女生分开。
We live in a very small house.
我们在一个比较小的房子。
So room is a scarcity.
所以就是房间是有限的。
So I had to sacrifice my work room to prepare a room for my daughter.
我需要牺牲我的工作室，让她成为我女儿的房间。
So one day, as I was doing that over the past few weeks, I stumbled into a bag that I have kept for a long time.
那时候我就看到一个我已经很久没有用的包包。
And in that bag, there is this camera.
在那个包包里面有一个相机哦。
The exact model, Yashica.
就是这个。
It was passed on to me by my father.
它是我父亲给我的。
I think it's probably dated since the 70s or around there, sometime during that time.
可能这相机可能已经很久历史，可能。
It can still be used.
还可以用的哦。
I wish I could. I brought them here, but I couldn't rush in time to go back home and take it up.
我希望就是能够去研究一下。
Now the one thing interesting about this camera is it needs to use a film.
可是这个相机有一个重点，就是它是一个胶片相机。
How many of you know what a film is?
你们知道什么是胶片吗
？Okay, not too bad. So this thing, you see that Kodak?
你可以看哇，这 Kodak 的。
I remember when I was young and my dad passed me that camera, I used to go to the shops and buy for like $6.91 for ISO 200, maybe $12 for ISO 400 film.
我记得那时候呢，就是当我父亲给了我这个相机之后呢，我去买了一些胶片。
And I went to Gurney Plaza on Thursday and checked. ISO 200 film is ringgit 25 today.
我之后我去 Gurney Plaza 看完说，哇，今天那个胶片竟然只要25块。
Now the problem with this film is with this camera is I need to pull the thing out a bit, insert it on one side, pull to the end, you know, and then click it back and then turn the thing around so that it just ready for me to snap pictures.
就组装这个胶片的时候，其实有很多步骤，我要小心的把它放进去，好确保它是可以使用的。
For the newer generation, if you are not aware, every film can only take 36 pictures.
哎，大家就是如果还不知道这是什么的话，这一张呢只能有36个照片。
Okay, so it's not like your phone today, right?
就不像你手机啦，拍了一下。
哎，你没有笑啊？可以再笑多一次吗？
来再笑多一次，拍多几张这样。
It's very precious because one photo costs you some money.
因为呢，那个是每一张照片都要计费的。
But I want to tell you this. Why am I telling this story?
为什么要跟你说这件事情呢
？I want to tell mothers are often like a camera.
我想说，就是母亲往往就像相机一样。
There are times you need to put the film into the camera and just protect it.
就是呢，母亲往往你要把那个胶片放进相机里面，然后你要保护它。
And mothers are the one that imprints whatever the photo, the picture on that film.
就是母亲，她是就保存这一些照片。
And then when you go and develop it, and it comes out a beautiful photo.
然后当就是出来的时候，它会是这样美好的照片。
And too often, you know, mothers are just like that. They protect us. They let us release us when the time is right.
往往呢，母亲就像这样，她们不断在保护我们。然后当对的时刻，她就让我们放我们走。
So today I want to just encourage everyone, especially the mothers.
今天我要鼓励每一个人，尤其是母亲。
From a story of a lady. Who is hardly mentioned in the Bible, but is she's mentioned a few times.
关于一个女人的故事，她可能你很少会看到她的名字，但是其实她有被提到几次。
The name of this lady is called Jochebed.
她的名字叫做约基别。
Or in Hebrew is Jochebed.
约基别。
So do you know who is this?
你们知道她是谁吗？
So this is actually Moses' mother.
她其实是摩西的母亲。
You know, the Bible have not many reference to her, but I thought, man, her life and her story is just amazing and inspiring.
即使在圣经里面没有很详细记录她的故事，但是我觉得她的故事是非常精彩的。
And if you want to be inspired, go and check out the new Moses documentary on Netflix.
大家可以去看那个摩西的纪录片在Netflix。
Now, if you were to look on, her name was actually mentioned in the book of Exodus, chapter 6, verse 20.
她的名字呢，其实是在出埃及记6章20节有讲到。
And it says here, Amram married his father's sister Jochebed, who bore him Aaron and Moses. Amram lived 137 years.
这里讲到，暗兰娶了自己姑母约基别为妻，约基别给她生了亚伦和摩西。暗兰一生的岁数是137岁。
So Jochebed is the mother of Aaron, Moses, and Miriam.
所以约基别她是亚伦、摩西和米利暗的母亲。
Interesting family, and all their kids are doing amazing things in the Bible.
看他们每一个孩子呢，都在圣经里面都成就了大事。
Now the name Jochebed in Hebrew, it means Yahweh is glory.
那约基别呢，它其实在希伯来文的意思是耶和华是荣耀。
And it's probably in the first time in this book that the name Yahweh is mentioned in somebody's name.
这是第一次我们看到呢耶和华的名字出现在其中一个人的名字里面。
So Jochebed, her name means God is glory.
所以约基别就是耶和华是荣耀。
So you could see how back in the Old Testament days, the name of a person actually means a lot to that person.
你可以看到就在旧约里面的一个人的名字是代表很多很多意思的。
All right, so let's go into the story, into her story in the book of Exodus chapter 2.
让我们来看一下她的故事，我们来看出埃及记2章。
All right, let's look at verse 1 and 2.
让我们来看出埃及记2章1到2节。
And he says, and a man of the house of Levi went and took as wife a daughter of Levi. So the woman conceived and bore a son, and when she saw that he was a beautiful child, she hid him 3 months.
有一个利未女子为妻，那女人怀孕，生了一个儿子，见她俊美，就把她藏了3个月。
And even the very first time when she was introduced, the Bible did not even mention her name.
即使她第一次被介绍的时候，甚至都没有提到她的名字。
But we know it's Jochebed.
但是我们知道她是约基别。
And if you were to know the story, the background of Exodus chapter 2,
如果你知道是在出埃及记2章这个故事，
because one chapter before this,
在前一个的章节是
King Pharaoh issued a decree because he was very worried that the Israelites are outnumbering the Egyptians.
法老担心希伯来人越来越多，所以他已经定下一个法令。
So he called all the midwives and told them if any son, baby boy is born, kill them.
他说如果任何希伯来人的男婴出生的话，把他们杀死。
If it's a baby girl, let them live.
如果是女孩的话，没关系，让他们活着。
And if you were to look in the Bible when we read, she hid him for 3 months because they were hunting, the soldiers were hunting for Hebrew boys and they want to throw them to the Nile River.
然后你看为什么摩西的母亲把他藏起来，因为当时他们都在追杀男婴。
And that explains why the Bible says she hid him for 3 months.
这就解释了为什么他们藏了他三个月。
But I want to show you something beautiful. The Bible says here, so the woman conceived and bore a son when she saw that he was a beautiful child.
这边圣经讲到，那女人怀孕生了一个儿子，见他俊美。
You know the word beautiful?
这里俊美讲到。
In the Hebrew word is the word tough.
在希伯来文这个字 tough.
It's the word tough that means good.
Tough 其实是好的意思。
You know, up to this point, the only time the word tough was used was in Genesis chapter 1.
在这一章之前呢，唯一一次 tough 这个字被用到呢，是在创世纪。
When God created the world.
当神创建世界的时候。
And remember, at the end of every day, God saw that it was good. God saw that it was tough.
当时神看到他的世界是他创造世界是好的，是 tough.
So ever since from the creation all the way until Exodus, this word never came up until now.
在那之后呢，这个词在圣经里面没有出现过，一直到摩西的出生。
So mothers have this ability.
所以母亲有这个能力
to see the tough in their kids.
看到孩子的美好。
So Jochebed can see this baby, and he knew that it is a good thing from God.
所以约基贝可以看到他孩子俊美，他看到这是一个来自神的好。
You know, as a mother, as a parent, we must be able to see the good in our child.
所以家长们，我们可以看到我们孩子们的好。
Not just the good for the moment. Oh, you're so cute. But the good that the baby is becoming.
不只是片刻的好，而是他即将成为的好。
You know, I know in Chinese there's this phrase, not nice at all.
我知道中文有一句话。
生嚿叉烧都好过生过你。
哦，生块叉烧都好过生你。You
know, I think the guy who invented that phrase loves 叉烧。
我可能就是人家喜欢叉烧。
You know, come on. You know, we as parents, we need to be able to see our child and the goodness that God has implanted in that child.
但是身为家长，我们应该要看到我们孩子的好，看到神在他里面的好。
And what does it mean for the child?
这对孩子来说什么意思呢？
Children, that means we can always go back to our parents because there is where we will find love, self-worth, and our values.
也就是说，孩子们，你要回到你的家里面，因为那是你找到你自己价值的地方。
You know, as parents and as a church community, like what Pastor mentioned, we are a big spiritual family.
就像牧师刚刚讲到的，我们有一个很大的属灵家庭。
We have a responsibility to proactively affirm the value and the potential that we see in every children.
我们有责任的让那些孩子们感到被重视。
You know, this is a big family.
这是一个大家庭。
You know, when we see Asher.
那我们看到 Asher 的时候
，When we see Nathan，
我们是 Nathan，
and every other kids，
我们和其他的所有的小孩
，I know sometimes they can be running and yelling and all that stuff。
我知道往往他们很多时候就会一直跑来跑去尖叫。
But when we look at them, can we see the good that God has placed in their life？
可是当我们看着他们的时候，我们能不能看到神在他们里面放下的好
？Then they will find this is the community that they will find self-worth。
然后我们会发现这是一个，这是一个可以看到他们价值的地方。
You know what's the problem? When they can't find that at home in their family, they will go to the world to find that value.
为什么这个很重要呢？因为如果他们没有办法在自己的家庭里面找到价值，他们会去外面找他们价值。
So parents,
家长们
，today,
家长们今天
，go back,
回家。
I mean, if your kids are not here,
如果你的孩子们在这里的话
，just put your hands on your son's face like that.
你就这样子去握着你孩子的脸。
Son, I see the tough in you.
跟他说，哦，我在你里面看到 tough.
Amen.
Amen.
And the Bible says this. So the woman conceived bore a son when she saw that he was beautiful. She hid him for 3 months.
我们这里看到呢，就是她是这女人生了一个儿子，见他俊美之后，就把他藏了三个月。
I don't know why the Bible or why she wants to keep Moses, baby Moses, for 3 months.
因为不知道为什么他藏的是藏三个月。
But I read this, I find that it's a reason because the mother needs to protect the child.
我发现其实原因是一名母亲要保护她的孩子。
You know, the main problem with us as parents, I am guilty of this.
我就是觉得有点愧疚了。
You know, our kids are exposed too much, too fast, too soon.
我们的孩子呢，他们太快、太多、太快、太早接触了。
You know, I just had a session with my son, you know, while we were driving back from KL this morning.
我们今天我今天跟我的孩子有了一个对话。
I say, son.
我说儿子啊。
For privacy sake, I will not tell you who is it.
我不要跟你们讲你们是谁了。
From now on.
从今天开始，从今天开始。
You are not allowed to play Brawl Star anymore.
你不可以再去玩这个游戏了。
So as a community, can you please don't play Brawl Star in front of my son, okay?
所以请大家不要在我的儿子面前玩这个游戏。
Now, church, a lot of times we need to protect them.
有很多时候我们要保护他们。
There is a time.We need to release.
也有时候我们要放手。
But we have to make sure that we guide them so that we don't release them too much, too fast, too soon.
可是同时呢，我们也要去指引他们，好让他们不要太多、太快、太早接触到外面的信息。
So parents, you dedicated your baby this morning.
所以家长们，今天你们献婴了。
You know, read to them that big Bible little kids.
让他们一起去读经。
Don't watch YouTube Kids. Start YouTube Kids later. Don't worry.
你们之后可以之后再看 YouTube Kids. 你们现在可以先来读经。
You know, we have to do a better job protecting our kids for the things they are not ready for.
我们需要做更好的工来保护我们的孩子。
You know, too often we often think that protection is a scary thing.
常常我们会觉得说保护是一个很可怕的东西。
But you know what? Protection is guidance, not isolation.
但是保护其实是指引，而不是隔离。
When you are protecting them, I mean, maybe you don't have a child today, but as you are protecting the younger generation, you are guiding them.
可能今天你还没有孩子，但是如果今天你在保护下一代的时候，你就在指引他们。
Not just merely isolating them from the world.
你并不是把他们从这世界上隔离。
You're teaching them the values, the godly values that they need to learn.
你是教导他们，他们应该学习的属神的价值。
Amen.
Amen.
And then in verse 3, Exodus 2 verse 3.
我们在第三节。
The Bible says, but when she could hide him no longer, she got a papyrus basket for him. Coated it with tar and pitch, then she placed the child in it and put it among reeds along the bank of Nile.
直到他不能把它再藏了，就拿一个蒲草箱来涂上沥青和石漆，把孩子放在里面，把箱子放在河边的芦苇丛中。
There will come a time, parents, that you will no longer know what to do and how to do.
家长，你会来到一个时候，是你不知道你还可以做什么。
But this is a time when you're going to trust God because God is going to do what you can't do.
但这就是你相信神的时候了，神可以做我们不能做的事情。You
know, as mothers, you have done everything that you know.
所以母亲，你已经做了所有你知道你可以做的事情。But
there will come a time there's nothing else that you can do.
但是你会遇到你不知道做什么的时候。You
just have to let go and trust God.
你只需要放手和相信神。Just
like Jochebed.
就像约基别。She
knew that that's the best she can do.
她知道她只可以做到这样了。And
she just let Moses go.
她就放摩西走。Now
I want to point something to you.
我要提到一点。
The Bible said, and put it among the reeds among the bank of Nile.
这里有讲到说，他把箱子放在河边的芦苇丛中。
I don't know if you know what are reeds. Reeds.
哦，就芦苇。
If you go to the river,
如果你在河边呢，
you will suddenly see a bushes of plants along the river.
你会看到很多的草丛。
Now those reeds, they are there to just filter out the, you know, rubbish or whatever stuff, that, so that it doesn't flow along the river.
然后芦苇呢，就是好像一个保护，这样它就不要让太多的过滤了，不要让一些垃圾就是直接流向河流。
So Jochebed didn't just take the basket and put it on the Nile River and then sing Let It Go.
然后过后呢，约基别他就把那个蒲草箱放在那边，然后开始唱Let It Go嘛。
No. In fact, that basket was just stuck along that reeds along the bank of river Nile.
而不是哦，他是把那个蒲草箱放在河边的芦苇丛。
So Jochebed was smart.
所以约基别是很聪明的。
She knew that she could just come back to the same spot again to see baby Moses.
她知道她可以再次回到这个地方来看到摩西。
You know, I know the hardest thing is just to for parents is just to leave your child and walk away.
因为很多时候作为家长，我们最难做的事情就是放手，然后放你孩子走，然后走开。
But I want to tell you, there's only one place that you can leave your kids and go away.
但是只有一个地方你可以把你孩子放心放走。
Little like this. Amen? Nobody agree. Okay, alright, okay. Alright. Now, I want to show you something interesting. The word basket.
我们看到这边讲到的 basket, 蒲草箱。
There was a word basket here. She got a papyrus basket for him.
她给他准备了一个蒲草箱。
Now, the word basket in Hebrew.
在希伯来文呢，这个 basket 这个词
is the word teva.
叫 teva.
Teva means an ark.
Teva 其实就是方舟的意思。
So if you were to read NKJV version, the word ark is actually mentioned there.
你可以看到就在 NKJV 版本的英文圣经，你可以看到 ark 这个字。
So where was this word mentioned in the Bible?
那这个字之前是在什么时候被提到的呢？
The word was mentioned in Genesis 6:13.
那是在创世纪提到的哦。
In the story of Noah, when God said, "Make yourself an ark, a teva of gopher wood, and make rooms in the ark, and cover it inside and outside with pitch."
是在创世纪六章十三节，你要用哥斐木做一艘方舟，方舟里面要做一些仓房，方舟的内外都要涂上沥青。
You know what? I love Jochebed.
你知道为什么我很喜欢约基别吗？
He trusts that God will take care and of Moses.
他相信神会照顾摩西。
That's faith.
这是信心,
but she did not just let the faith stop there.
但她并不只是纯粹的只有信心。
She did her best to construct an ark.
她就尝试了自己的最好，让把这个方舟做到最好。
So the baby Moses will be protected.
这个摩西可以被保护。
So the Bible said she used three different materials.
这里圣经有讲到，她用了三个材料哦。
Number one is a papyrus.
第一个是蒲草。
Asphalt bitumen.
蒲草、沥青和石漆
and a pitch.
石漆.
So basically, the first item is what she used to construct the basket.
所以第一个呢，蒲草是就是成为那个箱子的结构.
The asphalt and the pitch were there to give a waterproofing capability.
而沥青还有石漆呢，是用来防水的.
you know what? Having faith is one thing.
你知道有信心是一件事。
You know, but preparation and attention to it is another.
但是你有没有去预备，有没有去重视，又是另外一件事情。
You know, she trusted God that God will take care of Moses because there was something good in this baby.
她相信神，她相信神一定会照顾摩西的。
But he did not just chinchai. Okay, lah, you go.
但她并不是哦，只是把宝宝丢在那边，讲你走吧。
She was resourceful to use what she had to craft a beautiful ark and a basket to protect the baby.
但是她却用她现在所有的去建造一个坚固的蒲草箱给她的孩子。
I want this to be a reminder to us.
我希望这可以提醒我们。
There are times in our life, I know sometimes the only thing that we can do is pray.
往往我们知道我们可以做的到这边。
But as we pray, that's one thing. If I could encourage you, ask God, is there something I can do?
除了祷告之外，你可以问神：神，我还可以做什么
？Because faith without action is dead.
因为我们有信心。
You know, Jochebed didn't just believe God's promises; she acted on it.
约基比他不单单是相信，而是他做出了行动。
Amen. And the Bible said this, and this is the interesting part. It was the introduction of another character.
然后呢，接下来我们就要看到另外一个角色的出现。
In verse 4,
在第四节
，The Bible said his sister Miriam.
这里讲到孩子的姐姐，也就是米利安
，stood at a distance to see what would happen to him, Moses.
远远的站着，要知道孩子究竟怎么样。
Then Pharaoh's daughter went down to the Nile to bathe, and her attendants were walking along the river bank. She saw the basket among the reeds and sent her female slave to get it.
那时法老的女儿下到河边去洗澡，她的使女们在河边行走。她看见了芦苇中的箱子，就打发自己的使女去把箱子拿过来。
Friends, Miriam was at the right.Place at the right time, and she had the right heart.
看米利安这时候呢，她是在正确的地点、正确的时间，有着正确的心态。
The history says she's probably about what, 8 to 9 years old.
当时呢，这边她米利安应该只有就是八九岁。
So I want to speak to all of you youths.
所以我跟每一个人都会被使用。
God can use people of all ages, including young children like Miriam.
神可以使用任何年龄的人，即使是一个像米利安这样八九岁的小孩
，to accomplish his purposes，
来成就他的旨意。
So God's timing is sovereign。
所以呢，神的旨意是有他主权的。
And the Bible says in verse 6, after sending the female slave to the basket，
那我们看到第六节
，she opened it and saw the baby. He was crying and she felt sorry for him. This is one of the Hebrew babies, she said.
他打开了，就看见了孩子。看啊，孩子哭了，他就怜悯他，说：“这是希伯来人的一个孩子。”
You know, sometimes you can find yourself in situation that is desperate. You're probably at the end of everything.
有时候你会觉得说：“哦，我现在是没有盼望了，结束了。”
God can send an outsider to come and rescue you.
神甚至可以叫外人来帮助你。
And you see, the Bible says when she saw the baby, she felt sorry for him.
这里甚至讲到，他看到孩子哭了，他就怜悯他。
God can cause an outsider to have a compassion on you.
神甚至可以要外人来对我们有同理心。
You know, God can bring people whom you least expect to come.To just help you and to rescue you.
他会用意想不到的人来拯救你。
But this is the most interesting part.
这就是最有趣的地方。
When Pharaoh's daughter said to her,
当
when Miriam would then come and say, Miriam suddenly just jump into the scene again.
然后跟米利安再次出场。
Would you want me to get somebody to nurse the baby for you?
他说要不要我去请一个奶妈来？
是不是奶妈？对啊 yeah. Okay, all right. So to just help her to nurse the child for you.
所以我们可以请她，就是帮你去照顾孩子。
All right. So should I go and find one from the Hebrew woman? So Miriam was smart.
所以米利安是很聪明的。
Because she had in mind was her mother.
因为她知道她的妈妈。
And Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Go." So the maiden went and called the child's mother.
所以呢，这法老的女儿就回答他说：“你去吧，然后同你继续把孩子的母亲请来了。”
I want to talk to all parents here.
我要跟所有的家长讲。
You know, sometimes you feel like giving up. There's nothing you can do for your child.
有时候你觉得你要放弃了，你觉得你对你的孩子没有东西可以做了。
You can only pray and trust God.
你只能够祷告和相信神。
You know, God will cause things like this to happen, that your child will be brought back to your presence again.
你知道神可能会透过这样子的事情，他会把你的孩子再次带到你的面前。
And look at what the big, what Pharaoh's daughter said to her. He says, Pharaoh's daughter said to Jochebed, he says, take this baby and nurse him for me, and I will pay you. So the woman took the baby and nursed him.
这里九节，法老的女儿对他说：“你把这孩子抱去，替我乳养他，我必给你工钱。”妇人就跑抱了孩子去乳养他。
So not only Jochebed gets baby Moses back, but now she's getting paid to nurse her own son.
所以约基比他不只是他的孩子回到他的身边，他甚至还因为照顾他有了工钱。
That was the provision of God.
这就是神的供应。
You know who would have ever knew few verses before that?
所以会想到会是这样子的发展呢。
When Jochebed put the basket at the reeds in the river Nile bank,
当约基别把那个蒲草箱放在河的时候
，God will cause the baby to come back to her home and then get paid to nurse baby Moses.
神不只让摩西回到他的家，而且还让他的妈妈因为照顾他有了工钱。
You may think it's the end of the road for you.
你可能会觉得这是结束了。
In your situation.
你的状况
in your family,
在你的家庭
in your kids,
在你的孩子
but you know what, if you trust God,
可是你知道当你相信神
have faith in Jesus,
在耶稣里面有信心
God might just bring the situation back to you and even with his provision
神会带着所有一切带回来甚至有他的供应
You know, this is interesting because based on the history, Jochebed probably took care of Moses until he was 3 or 4 years old.
就是因为呢，就约基别，约基别他后来呢，甚至照顾摩西，一直到他三四岁。
And she got paid for it.
他有拿工钱哦。
How amazing is that?
是不是很美好
？And verse 10.
十节。
And the child grew.
十节。
And she brought him to Pharaoh's daughter, and he became her son. So she called his name Moses, saying, "Because I drew him out of the water."
第十节，孩子长大了，妇人把他带到法老的女儿那里，他就做了法老女儿的儿子。他给孩子起名叫摩西，说：“因为我把他从水里拉出来。”
You know what? There's nothing more painful for a mother than to give up your child for the second time.
对于一个妈妈来说，要第二次放弃她的孩子是真的是非常痛苦的。
And she probably knew this would be the last time.
她可能知道这就是永远了。
But Jochebed's act of giving up Moses a second time demonstrates her continued trust in God's plan and her willingness to sacrifice her own desire for her son's greater purpose.
但是约基别第二次放下摩西的行为就代表他会继续相信神的计划以及他愿意牺牲他对儿子的渴慕来成就更大的目的。
And the name Moses was given by Pharaoh's daughter.
摩西呢是法老的女儿取的名字。
You know, sometimes...Letting go is probably the hardest part of holding on to faith.
有时候放手才是坚守信心最难的部分。
Sometimes letting go is the hardest part of holding on to faith.
有时候放手才是坚守信心最难的部分。
You know what? Up to this point,
你知道在这几点
，Moses had two mothers.
摩西还有两个母亲。
Two mothers gave him something.
两个母亲都给了他不同的东西。
Moses' Egyptian mom.Gave his son affluence.
他的埃及的母亲给了他富裕。
His Hebrew mom gave him influence.
他的希伯来母亲给了他影响力。
I'm not sure if you can catch this in your spirit.
你能够明白吗
？I mean, as parents, we want to give our kids the best, the nicest, and everything.
身为家长，我们总会想要给我们孩子最好的。
And too often we missed out on the influence part.
常常我们就是缺少了影响力。
And we just outsource everything to the little lightest teachers.
我们把所有东西就外包给了我们的主日学老师。
Can he will learn how to pray in church?
我们讲说啊，好，去学祷告吧，你在主日学。
If he doesn't learn when he go to Joey's youth, Joey will teach him.
然后就可能可以跟 Joey 学那东西。
Guys, it's a partnership, not an outsourcing.
这个其实就重点，这不是外，我们不应该让把它变成外包，而是我们是一起努力的。
You know, as Chinese, as Asians, we thought, you know, the man will go out there, work hard, and now these days, probably the women probably earn more than men as well. Okay, so you know, the parents want to go out and make more money so that they can give them the best things.
然后常常我们亚洲人会讲说，哦，家长要努力的出去工作，然后过后呢，才可以给孩子最好的。
Don't just give your child affluence, but give them influence.
让我们不要只是给孩子富裕，而是给他们带来影响力。
Give them influence.Godly influence at home.
给他们属神的影响力在家里。
You know, as you protect him within your home.
当你在保护他的时候。
You know, as he grow up in your influence.
然后当他长大之后呢，给他影响力。
And as the time comes for you to release your child.
当时机到了，你需要放手。
You know, you will trust that he has learned all that he need to learn from you.
但你就会相信他当时已经学到所有你要他学的东西。
And this lady Jochebed was amazing because even in Hebrews chapter 11, she was mentioned there.
然后约基别呢，其实在希伯来书也是有提到。
And it says here, by faith, Moses, when he was born, was hidden 3 months by his parents because they saw he was a beautiful child, tough, and they were not afraid of the king's command.
在希伯来书十一章二十三节，因这信，摩西的父母。在摩西生下来以后，因为见孩子俊美，就把他藏了三个月，不怕王的命令。
Parenting sometimes take risks.
育儿有时候是很就有风险的。
I know it's hard sometimes.
我知道很困难。
This year I sent my daughter to Fires Camp for the first time.
像今年我的女儿第一次参加星火营。
And I was actually looking at her from afar, you know.
我其实从远远在那边看她。
She's not here, it's okay. Alright, And I was like, hey, I was telling my wife, how come the whole time he just walks by herself, eat by herself, you know, play by herself, no interaction.
我就在那边观察他，我讲，然后我就跟我太太讲说，哎，为什么我们女儿她一直都是自己一个人的，自己一个人吃饭，一个人走来走去，没有去跟别人有互动。
Then at home we wondering, okay, so tonight at dorm will she talk to someone or will she finally exchange names, exchange numbers or stuff like that?
然后就开始想说，她到底有没有跟人家讲话，有没有跟人家去更多的联系等等。
But there was nothing we could do.
但是我不能做什么。
I mean, I could call Joey and say, "Hey, could you please make sure, you know?"
我只能够找 Joey 找帮手。
But we just got to trust God.
但是我们还是要相信神。
Amen.
Amen.
Can I get the musicians to come up?
那我们请我们敬拜团上台来。
Now, one of the things that you could do, parents.
作为家长，我们还有一件事情可以做的。
I spoke to all those parents who dedicated their child.
刚刚我有跟就是那一些就是献殷礼的家长们聊天。
One of the most amazing things you can do as parents is to share your testimony.With your kids.
身为家长，你能做最好的就是把你的见证分享给他们。
You know, I remember one day in the car when my wife was not around, as I was driving them to school.
有一次就是当我太太不在，我带孩子去上学。
And I told my kids, the two younger kids.
我跟我两个小的孩子说。
I share with them my testimony, how I came to Christ at 12 years old, how I was a very bad student, lazy student, and all that stuff.
我刚刚分享我的故事，我想说我是怎么样在信主，我怎么样曾经是不好的学生等等。
And I say this verse, Jesus grew in favor with God and man when he was 12 years old.
他说就是神把一个人带一个人成长，就当他在十二岁的时候。
And I say I wanted that.
我说我要这样子。
And I told my kids, so one night at room after my dad was being called to the principal office.
然后呢，就是有一天呢，当我的爸爸被叫去，就是被叫去校长室。
Because I didn't send homework, because I didn't do anything, I was just very naughty.
就当时因为我顽皮，所以家长被叫到训导室。
And I know my dad for the first time in my life shouted at me, give me one, what my kids will call NTS.
当时我爸爸第一次给了我一个就是 NTS.
A nice tight slap.
就是一个很大的巴掌。
You want to study or you want to go opposite the road and sell?Ice water.
我爸爸讲说，你要好好读书，还是你要去那边街边卖食物
？The whole day I couldn't do anything.
然后
The whole day I can't do anything.
那时候我完全不能做什么。
I felt the guilt was just so heavy.
我就觉得我非常的有罪恶感。
And in my room.
在我的房间。
That night before I slept.
那天我睡觉之前。
And all those scenes of me getting punished, not sending homework, stealing my friend's stuff, taking my friend's ruler.All that kind of stuff appeared one by one, like a CCTV screen.
在睡觉之前呢，就是所有我闪回所有我做过的所有的一切的坏事。
You know, the more I see that, I feel like, oh man, it's just very hard.
当我在看的时候，我就觉得真的非常难受。
And then suddenly I saw you know those days, the Pemadam Papan Hitam, you know, there is this oval shape type one.
你知道以前有一个那个黑板擦吗
you know that? Yeah. So I begin to see a hand taking the.Everything away.
我看到说有一个那个黑板擦把所有这一切都擦掉。
And I hear, I knew it was God.
我知道那是神。
And God just said, Isaac, from today on, I'm wiping all this. I'm giving a new beginning.
神说 ，Isaac， 从今天开始，我把所有一切的过去都擦掉，你有一个新生。
I was crying in my room at 12 years old, crying and crying and crying and crying.
那时候十二岁，我在我的房间不断的哭泣。
So I told my kids, I said, on that night.
我跟我的孩子讲。
On that night, I met God.
我说那一天晚上我遇见神了。
So there's one thing that's going on with our family.
这就是在我们的家庭里面发生的事情。
So every night after the fires camp.
所以在每晚星火营的晚之后。
I mean I know Ruben is he has baptized he is assured of his salvation.
像Ruben 他已经受洗了。
So I always text Rennie at night before she sleeps.
在睡觉之前呢，我就会信息他。
So how was Fire's Camp?
我说那个星火营怎么样啊
？Did you meet God?
我说你有遇见神吗
？Every time I just pray, she replied yes.
我只是祷告，他然后他就回复。
You know, it is not something I can force through.
并不是一个我可以去强迫的东西。
But I'm praying.
但是我祷告。
I'm praying.
我祷告。
I'm praying the day will finally come.
我祷告那一天一定会到来。
Then my child said, "Dad, I meet God."
然后我的孩子说。把我遇见神了。
So as a parent, I always pray for their salvation.
所以希望呢，我为这所有的家长们祷告救恩。
You know, God will come.
神会来到。
God will come true.
神会来到。
You know, if you've been praying for a family member's salvation, you know, I just want to tell you, just like Jochebed's story.
如果你在为着你的任何家人的救恩祷告，你要想一想约基别的故事。
See, there's nothing else that she could do.
她不能再做什么了。
But she just need to trust God.
她只是相信神。
And God will come.
神会来到。
At the right time.
在对的时间
with his provision
在他的供应
and the best thing that happened in Fire's Camp this year
那今年呢就星火营开发
I've been praying for Ruben a lot
我为这Ruben 祷告了很多
and he told me after the second session
他在第二个节目之后告诉我
and he just received the gift of tongues
他就领受到了神
Wow, come on, let's give God a big, big shout of praise You know what?
知道吗
and that is why a communityIn church is important.
这就是为什么教会的社群是那么重要的。
It is important.
这是非常重要的。
I'm not perfect.
我并不是完美的。
My wife is not perfect.
我的太太不是完美的。
But where we are weak and where we fail at,
当我们觉得我们很软弱的时候
that's where you guys can compliment us.
这就是你们可以帮助我们的时候了。
And this is what the word of God says, encourage one another as it is still called day.
就我们要彼此的鼓励。
So parents today, if you are here,
所以今天家长们你在这里
You've been praying for your child
如果你在为着你的孩子祷告
No matter how old are they
不管他们几岁
And hoping that they will find God
我祷告他们都能够找到神
You know, I just want to tell you I know for sure God will show up at the right time
我知道神会在对的时刻显现
Or maybe you're not married today
可能你今天还没有结婚
You don't have a child It's like, what is this Isaac talking about? Nothing to do with me
可能你还没有孩子你也不知道我现在可以做什么
But you probably find yourself in a situation like Jochebed
但是你可能也会面对约基别面对的这场景。
You've done all that you could.
你已经做了所有你可以做的。
You have no more strategy left.
你已经没有后盾了。
You have squeezed every ounce of wisdom from you.
你已经把所有你尽力的都挤出来了。
And here you are, and in Mother's Day 2024, you are at a situation you don't know how else to move on.
然后今天此时此刻，你还在觉得我不知道我应该怎么往前走。
I want you to look at.Jochebed's story.
我要你看到约基别的故事。
As a testament of God's faithfulness.
它是一个很好的见证。
That He will never, never, never leave you.
他不会离弃你。
You know, just continue to trust and pray and trust and pray and trust and believe.
让我们继续的信靠，继续的祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Can we do that?
Okay.
You know, why don't we all just stand on our feet and let us sing this beautiful song and let the worship team lead us.
让大家一起站立起来，一起唱这首歌。